And welcome back. This is the RPG Chick, and we just, last episode we finished, we defeated the Sky Dragon, and we all leveled up to level 11. Which, I don't know if it even says there, but it says it here. So let's see if we have an easier way back than, I guess so. So we can head right to Old Song. We've got all these birds for this guy, and then we'll head to Elm's Reach and talk to Barath. No, Hylea, actually. Hate when that happens. He's around here somewhere. I actually have a little bit of misgivings turning in this quest to him. He says he's gonna eat all the birds. It's not any of these guys, right? Yeah, he's around here somewhere. Keeping fast mode on just so I can find this guy quicker. Daughter. Where the hell is this guy? Where the hell are you? I'm missing him somehow, obviously. He's around here. These no-name people hanging around. Where's Echo? Oh, Old Song's Pass. We haven't been up there, have we? What's up Old Song's Past? Pass. Oh, just a way out. Okay, never mind. Never mind. I didn't think I'd feel the warmth return to Old Song. Ah! Delem. Name still reminds me of Delem from Babylon 5.
Many blessings, traveler.
Greeting, friend. How goes the bird hunt? I spoke with Lindsay. She said eating songbirds is just a superstition. It won't help you sing. Nonsense! Delem shakes his head in disbelief. I know a man who swears by the practice. This has been part of how master chanters refine their craft for ages. Surely a wise woman such as herself would be familiar with the folklore and know that I speak of time-honored truths. I'm actually interested in the answer to this. Let me ask you this. Do sparrow hawks sing well? Well, they can shriek loudly, but I wouldn't call it melodic. And yet their favorite meal is a songbird, so if your belief is correct... I'm liking this. You're saying I should consume a sparrowhawk? Oh, wait. Oh, I see. He frowns and his posture slackens. But maybe the sparrowhawk doesn't have a soul, and that's why. He shrugs, his face blushing. You're right. This is silly. I'm just desperate for creative passion, and I'm walking the wrong path to find it. Why did we lose the Shardwing Songbird? Huh. Thank you, my friend. I don't need rare songbirds. I just need to find some inspiration from within. He bows to you with a pained smile. If you'll pardon me, I should stop delaying and write a new song. Why do we lose these birds anyway? Average adventure completed. Okay, I couldn't find my mouse. Oh, what's going on here? Oh, I thought she was running up to talk to us. Alright, so, what did we just finish? Songs of the Wild. After speaking with Lems, the owner of one of the rare songbirds, I learned that Delem's plan is based on Wild Orland superstition. I was able to convince him of the error of his plan, and he reluctantly abandoned the notion. And I let the birds free, I suppose. That's what happened after that. Okay. This is weird. We could actually just... Not a Glamfellen, but an Estremor cleansed noon frost. Got that right, buddy. I'm the Estremorin with the bestest? I don't know. I got nothing. Time to head back to the temple. Talk to the gods. South Curtain Wall will be done. You just have to do West Curtain Wall, and then the library again. And we'll see what else gets undone in the meantime. I can't believe this crap. Once I install the DLC, I'll get myself up to current version, and maybe that will fix my problems. We talked to Rhiannon and Sheeta still talks to us. Okay. How pretty. I forgot how this looked. It's been a while. Hylea. You stand once more before the Shrine of Hylea. The stars of her constellation seem to glitter all the brighter. You kneel. While you pray, you feel the space around your body shift and melt, and you find yourself in a vision of the mountaintop temple. Yet you see neither worshippers nor a dragon, but a tree. Its limbs wrap around the perimeter of the temple, tapering into twigs and branches of all sizes and angles. They seem too long and too numerous to be held up by the meager trunk, but they hold steady in the breeze. A single sparrow lands on the nearest branch. It watches you. I'm gonna throw a rock at it. I seek an audience with Hylea. The sparrow cocks its head in that peculiar bird-like fashion. Okay, we're gonna whistle at the bird. Or to the bird. You whistle the first tune that pops into your head. The sparrow blinks its beady eyes and hops closer to you along the branch. It bobs its tiny head and opens its beak, and the rich, trilling melody that spills forth is the song of a chorus of birds. A massive flock descends with a thundering of wings and whooping, screeching, chirping calls. They fill the boughs of the tree by the thousands, birds of every shape, size, and color nestling next to one another. Palagina sighs heavily. To be honest, I really can't stand birds. Are you serious, Palagina? I'm not going to say anything. That would be rather awkward, but, okay. A breeze ripples through the air. That was random. The limbs sway, creaking with a strange, gentle rhythm. A few hundred of the birds flit from their branches, forming a brilliantly variegated flock in front of the tree. As they meet and swoop in unison, you catch a glimpse of someone looking back at you, cloaked by the flurry of feathers. Kanna says, "Look there, the mantle of feathers. We are in the court of birds, and there stands the Sky Mother."
You journeyed to my temple and rid it of the dragon. Now my faithful may return, singing their joy to the skies and praising me through their creation.
I just wanted to kill a dragon. Life is creation and celebration. I'm glad to have served you in this. The breeze blows through the tree. A dove tucks its head into its feathers and watches you. How could it watch me if it just tucked its head into its feathers?
Glad because you seek to protect life, or because you seek a patron?
Both.
And yet you have proven yourself with this task. I would tell you of another.
I already know that Theos Ix Arcanon has gone to Sun and Shadow to strengthen Whitaker with thousands of souls. The birds return to the tree and nestle among their peers. The breeze ripples through the branches again, carrying the goddess's voice.
Then you have earned the favor of another. But stopping Theos will not heal the Deerwood. You must guide the trapped souls back to the bodies they were stolen from. Hollowborn children whose eyes have never seen the sun.
Excellent. I like this idea better than just, like, destroying the souls or letting them flow free into the air and get lost. Yeah. Guide the trapped souls back into the Hollowborn. You could restore them. Give their families hymns of joy after years of lament. The breeze tickles your ear. Peace and restoration give purpose to suffering. There is no meaning, no redemption in pain that does not lead to fulfillment. Symmetry demands that great rejoicing follow suffering such as this. I am not sure that it's possible to truly undo the harm Theos has caused. You hear the cry of a swift... You hear the cry of a swift, soft and plaintive. Perhaps the years cannot be forgotten, and for some, perhaps it is already too late. But if you could restore even one soul, kindle one spark of life, raise one voice in joy, it would be worth it. I agree, actually. There's another side to this, Alas says, his tone cautious. You've seen the consequences of a soul disjointed from its own cycle. Could these children ever truly return? Seems like an important decision here. Perhaps it would be better to allow these souls to find new lives? How can they continue to another when they have not fully lived this life? To pass them along to another now is cutting a stanza from a poem, a verse from a song. Thank you, Hylea. I will continue to Sun and Shadow.
When you reach the burial isle, you will find souls there that I have granted reprieve for their sins. I give these to you. For only they can bear you to safety on your journey down. And when you face Theos and the rotting fruits of his endeavors, remember the conversation we have had. In that moment, you will have power rivaling a god's. And after it, you will live in the world that you have chosen.
I will live in the world that I have chosen. Am I going to be choosing between two or more different worlds to live in? Okay. So the souls there can bear us to safety on our journey down. Okay.
Choose Restoration Watcher. Return the souls to the bodies they were stolen from. Swear to me that you will do this. And I shall give you power to make even Woodica quake. I can be merciful and terrible, Watcher.
Great wings, dark against the sun, unfold behind the tree, casting a blinding shadow across the temple for the briefest of moments. Yeah, out of the other choices, I feel this is best. I swear to return the souls to the hollow-born children of the Deerwed. And I shall remember. The dark wings snap shut, and the tiny sparrow flits to your shoulder. It tilts its head back and opens its beak, and the song that spills forth is like nothing you've ever heard. Melodies, at once mournful and beautiful, entrance you. The world becomes a place of pure color and sound. Each perfect moment follows the next like the lines of a poem or the bar of a song.
Wait! I'm not done with you.
Yes, Palagina? I've been granted Hylea's boon. Palagina steps forward inside the flock of birds. And then she says that. Birds wheel above. No, sorry. Birds wheel and pivot, showing a flash of pale feathers. Who is this that speaks in anger? Please forgive Palagina's boldness, Hylea. Passion is but another side of my nature. There is nothing to forgive. The birds settle on the branches and regard Palagina.
It's not often that any of our kind get the chance to speak to their... What should I call you? My mother, father, those words seem to fall short and yet be too generous given our history.
The birds cock their heads, craning and twisting their necks to look at one another. You are angry with me.
What did you expect? Should I be happy? To be like this? To live like this? What kind of creator does this to her creation and abandons it in a world this cruel?
And should I have plucked you from your home, wrapped you in my wings, and brought you to a nest like this one? Some tranquil and harmonious place far from the war chants and battle dances you love so well? A hawk shivers, ruffling its feathers. Tell me what you want.
All I've ever wanted from any of your kind is to take some responsibility. Any responsibility for what you've done to us, to every one of the children you've abandoned.
All the godlike ones. Huh. The birds flap their wings, rising from the branches. You are a song of ferocity, and one I love well. I hear your furor and rage, and it is music. Your prowess and valor leave a trail like a tapestry upon the world. I would not dampen your song, even with the comfort of my wings.
What does that mean? Come back here!
Palagina shouts angrily into the retreating flock of birds. But there is no response. Palagina's fists clench in frustration. I'm sorry you didn't get the answers you were looking for, Palagina. You deserve better.
We all deserve better.
Her shoulders slump in resignation. All right. Well, she says it's hurry, Watcher. You must stop Theos before it's too late to reverse this tragedy. Alright, yeah, I guess we'll continue on. I just want to see what that is. Hylea's boon. Plus one perception and plus one lore. A blessing from the goddess Hylea. Well, I guess this isn't our total, like, of the gods effect. Yeah, I guess that'll come when we get closer. Yeah, nothing else to do now except head on to that, what is it? Off of Old Song. I even see that. Who's obvious? It is Burial Isle. We must get there from Old Song. Actually, I should have gone just to the temple first, instead of heading to Old Song, and then back to... then to Twin Elms, and then back to Old Song. Oh well. What are you gonna do? Burial Isle, here we come. Dorval.
Builder's wisdom to you.
A thin, ragged man stands waiting on the barge, leaning on the oar. A smile of greeting splits his weathered features. It has been a very long time since an outsider sought passage to the Burial Isle. It's been a long time, actually, since we talked to him about this, so let me just ask him again. What is this Burial Isle? It is a sacred place, for it sits upon the great works of the builders. There, by our ancestors, all our animfaths are laid to rest. Few go there, my friend. It is not a place for the living to walk. Is it dangerous? He nods solemnly. Those I bring to the island return the same way, or else not at all. It is home only to the dead. Spirits, shades of the builders remain, and watch over our animfatha. They are bound to the island and protect it fiercely. Sounds like loads of fun. Take me across. He inclines his head in acknowledgement. I will. Take care that you do not lose your footing. These waters have a fickle temper. Cool. So we're gonna have to fight our way through shadows and specters and all kinds of fun stuff first, I'm sure.
I have trod more secret and sacred places in your company than I could have imagined.
I remember when I was a girl, and the missionaries came and told us about the gods. They said we could see them in the stars.
Iovara looks off in the distance at something only she can see.
I remember when I heard that. I snuck out at night and climbed the watchtower in the old fort, because I wanted to see them better. That fort burned down a few years ago when we cast the missionaries out. It was the missionaries who set fire to it. They didn't want us to be able to use it. Shame. There was history in that fort.
I'm not sure which one to say. That fort had outlived its use. It was a false sense of security. Okay, she's not talking. It was that. For me, as much as anyone, seeing it burn, it made me think. She looks at you. This is your home as much as it is mine. Do you worry about it? I worry about you. Is this the one that she's our mentor? We've decided that she's our mentor. You should be more worried about yourself. Half the guards still plot your death at night.
I miscalculated many things since this began. I'm relieved you weren't one of them. It's a good thing we didn't hang you.
Is it really, like, so much for them to just voice the other lines? I mean, there's not that much. There's not that many that, you know, are missing.
I always knew this path would have consequences, but I never wanted to see Kratom suffer on my behalf. I don't think I can stay here any longer. I am told the Inquisition is gathering an army, that they have sent messengers to bargain with rulers from distant lands. Kratom is not built to withstand a siege. If war is coming, I should be doing what Theos is doing. I will need allies. Allies on a stronghold that can resist an invading army.
You can feel words form long ago, rising in your throat like a toxic black bile. Have you thought about Acionis? That is.
Acionis? They have held off many would-be invaders, and their king has no love of the Inquisition's faith. I wonder, would he listen?
Still hovering there. Oh. Okay. Anything to see around here? I will not return, finish my business here. Alright, another place to explore.
Let's see what lies this way.
Spotted a shade. We've found a lot worse. A specter, three shades, and a phantom. And for some reason, Durance is leading the charge. Using a pillar. I could see the shade, so I'm gonna go for this shade. He might just kill it outright, I'm not sure. Yeah. Get that sheet. We can see it. What? So. We got another shade joining. Can't see stuff. Oh, a Shenguala too. I missed that. Spectre is badly injured, at least. She has to cast that still.
Brave does not believe.
Oh boy, that's not good. He's paralyzed? That's no good. Suppress affliction. Burn, suckers! We got rid of the Spectre, apparently. Can't see that way. You know, can we move him, like, so he can see? Wait, what do we do? Click that. It's right on him, basically.
Following your lead.
Okay, now. Need a little help there. And even more help.
Most inconvenient.
Are we fighting back or he's paralyzed? Is she just standing there not doing anything? I hate that.
Hey.
Oh, we've gotten rid of that. Okay, good.
Hey.
Guys, come around. Okay.
Yes.
Got rid of that? Okay, everybody on this one then. Which you can barely see for some reason, looks like a bag. Wow. That was fun.
Be cautious. Be constant.
Bury Lyle, everyone. Stay tuned next time when we explore more of this land of specters and ghosts and such. Excuse me. Thanks for watching. See you next time and endure. In enduring, go strong.